Hello everyone, and hello Dr. Iqbal. I'm Ku Jie Suan, and I'm from Team Rebel Roof. And my teammates are Chan Jun Yao, Rachel Lim, and also Jasmine Chan. So today we are going to talk about this state machine diagram. So before we get into our use case, so let me briefly talk about this state machine diagram. Alright, so what is this state machine diagram? Actually, it's being used to describe the different state of an entity. So because we know that actually an entity is not just a response to the corresponding inputs of it, but actually it's also depends on the presenting state of it. So we can say that it's actually response to various events by changing from one state to another. And therefore, we also can say that this UML SMD diagram is actually being used to model a dynamic nature of a system. Alright, so let's move on. Why do we use this state machine diagram? So as I said before, this state machine diagram is mainly being used to describe those state dependent behavior for an object. So this is because an object responds differently to the same event depending on currently what state it is in. Alright, so and of course this state machine diagram is not only just being applied on the object, is also can be applied to any elements that have a behavior to the other entities. So for example, there are use case and also methods and also some like subsystems. So these are all that can be applied and then be present by this state machine diagram. Alright, so that's the brief. So I now pass to my friend.
Hi, my name is Rachel. Then I will continue with the basic concept of state machine diagram. First of all, what is a state? It's an abstraction of the attribute values and links of an object. The set of values are grouped together into a state according to the properties that affect the gross behavior of the object. So from the state notation here, we can see that other than the name of state, the entry activities, current activities, exit activities, and the event trigger will also listed here. Then we continue with the characteristic of state machine notation. In general speaking, a state occupies an interval of time and is often associated with an abstraction of attribute values of an entity that satisfies certain conditions. As the state represents the condition of an object at certain point in a time, so the object can be viewed as moving from state to state. So the transition of the object from one state to the another state is known as automatic transition if there is no event and action occurs. The difference between the action and activities here is that the action is an atomic execution and it can be complete without any interruption, whereas the activities is an ongoing activity and it might run for a long duration. And it also might be interrupted by the event where it will cause the event cannot be completed.
Hi, I'm Jasmine. Now let's talk about notation in state machine diagram. So in a simple state machine diagram, we should always include initial state and also final state. So each of these blue boxes represented as states, and each of these arrows is represented as their action. So in action, we have two different types, which is entry action and also exit action. So it depends on the direction of each of the arrow. If the arrow points towards the state, we call it as entry action. If it's in the opposite side, we will call it as exit action. So next notation is substate. So let's look at the big box here. So this is actually a state called as cooling state. So in this state, we can see there's a lot of smaller state. This smaller state is called as substate, or we also call it as nested substate. So if a state that contains a lot of substate, we can actually call this whole thing as a composite state. Next, history state is actually can be found inside a composite state. So the main function of history state is to allow us to re-enter back to the last substate that we have done previously before we exit. So this is actually to reduce some repetitive step in order to start the whole thing from the initial state to the final state again and again. And the last notation is concurrent state. So concurrent state allow us to fork up into two different, like in this example, it fork up into two different concurrent states, and each of these states will be running parallelly, which is running together until the final state. Okay, now let's move on to our use case study. So me and my teammates decided to use automated teller machine, ATM machine, in order to be our case study material. So as we all know, ATM machine is actually a machine that allow customer to complete our basic transactions without the help of a branch representative or teller. So ATM machine, in order to allow us to do with money withdrawal, is actually requires a lot of procedure, such as you have to enter your bank card, you have to enter your PIN number, and you have to click this button, click that button in order to get your money. So we can say that ATM actually consists of multiple operational states and have different logics and behavior in each state. This is why we decided to use ATM in order to fulfill the requirement of state machine diagram that can display something that have complex states.
Hello everyone, I'm Chan. So based on the previously described use case, right now let's take a look at the state diagram of the ATM system. So the users start to interact with the system by inserting their card into the machine. Soon after that, the ATM system will display a main menu and feedback to the user that they are trying to verify the card. So at this point, at this state, the machine will request a PIN number from the user. And soon after the user have provided their PIN number, the ATM system will try to verify whether the PIN number supplied is correct or not. So in the case where the PIN number provided is wrong, an error will be displayed on the machine to give feedback to the user and immediately eject the card so that the user can collect their card and try again. So in the case where the PIN provided is correct, the transaction can be proceeded, where a main menu will be displayed to the user so they can choose whatever transaction they want to proceed. Over here, we describe a simple balance inquiry transaction. So if the user picked the balance inquiry, the ATM machine will display the balance of the user in the bank. Soon after that, the user will be dismissed and being provided to the main menu, where they can select another transaction they wish to carry out. In this case, they can select a request withdrawal amount. They can withdraw an amount of money. So before we let the user to withdraw their money, we need to verify whether the money they tried to withdraw is sufficiently enough from their bank account. So if the amount they requested is smaller or equal to the balance in their bank account, they can process, the ATM will proceed with the transaction and dispense the cash required and the receipt of the transaction. Finally, the user gets to collect their money and the card is being ejected to return to the customer. So this state diagram is a complete representation of the state and behavior of the ATM machine. As a conclusion, the state machine diagram leverages on the UML notation system to stand as a complete and intuitive diagram to describe the state and behavior of a certain system. By providing the state machine diagram in early stages of development, programmers and developers can have a clear mindset of how the system behaves in every state, hence can prevent erroneous state or bug preemptively. So that's all from us. Thank you very much.